So hi and welcome back to the show. My name is Gavin McRae and I'm from GJ McRae Foundation Repair. And this is our new video series where we tackle all things basement waterproofing and foundation repair related here in the Greater Toronto Area. We call this series In the Field, where we not only break down the premise of foundation repair, but also show you a complete time-lapse production of a full repair process after this top-down video is complete. So let's get right into it. So the repair was an out-of-town project just north of Toronto in a region called Blue Mountain. And this area has some of the only mountains per se in Ontario. And it's a very well-known area for skiing and snowboarding. And it's really an amazing winter wonderland type setting come January. So it was truly a pleasure to sort of get out of town for some foundation repair up in the mountains of Ontario. So this client had previously built a log cabin type chalet very close to the base of Blue Mountain. And it was quite a beautiful structure overall, but the concrete foundation walls themselves were basically built with ICF forming, which is basically a styrofoam insulated type of concrete form. Now, generally, this style of forming is an excellent solution for foundation structures that sort of just touch the frost line, or structures that will have backfill soil on both sides. In other words, ICF forming is really fantastic for structures that won't have excavated basements, because although there are major thermal and forming benefits to using ICF as a foundation wall, if there is a full basement on the other side of that foundation wall, the ICF forming over time, the real trick is really finding a way to properly waterproof this style of foundation wall, because of course on both sides of these types of walls there's literally styrofoam, and removing that styrofoam to waterproof the concrete sort of beneath after the fact is extremely difficult. So getting a standard waterproofing membrane installed directly to the concrete wall behind these ICF forms can prove to be nearly impossible at scale. So if ICF forms leak, they really aren't easy to waterproof. So that was the basic premise of the project overall. So we started by excavating around the entire perimeter of the foundation walls of the chalet, all the way down to the footings. And essentially that exposed all of the ICF foundation walls all in one shot. Next, once we opened things up, we found an application that was previously applied directly to the ICF forms themselves. And of course that was Blueskin. Now, many areas of the Blueskin application unfortunately failed to stick. So we peeled off any loose areas of that Blueskin around the perimeter of the chalet. And then we cleaned and dried the wall. The next step was installing a rubberized liquid membrane to the exterior of the Blueskin product around the whole perimeter of these foundation walls. And after that application, we essentially installed a very special fabric type laden drainage board, commonly referred to as Meridrain, because the dimples in this drainage board actually face outwards with this product. And the fabric attached to the dimples on this drainage board helped to separate sediment from groundwater. And this allows for excellent vertical drainage of these walls without the water physically needing to touch the concrete or the ICF walls themselves. So this is a much more expensive type of waterproofing application, but for ICF foundation waterproofing, this combination of materials is really crucial given the makeup and the style of this kind of wall. So additionally, the weeping tile system around the perimeter of these foundation walls was unfortunately basically blocked with roots and sediment, because this old weeping tile was basically installed without any fabric or filter cloth around it. So that was a huge issue in regards to, you know, hydrostatic pressure, because water just couldn't move fast enough away from the structure to be effectively drained away with this old system. Plus the winter snow and thaw up in that region of Ontario can be quite dramatic. And without a proper draining weeping tile system, the exterior of these ICF foundation walls were likely immersed in water for quite a long time, which unfortunately led to damage and unfortunately basement leaks. So once the waterproofing detail was completed with the liquid rubberized membrane and a fabric-laden mirror drain, plus a brand new weeping tile system was installed around the complete perimeter of the home, of course. And then we installed a new sump basin and pump, a battery backup system as well. And we added a few new cedar window wells and essentially covered all of the weeping tile system with clear gravel. and then we backfilled and power tamped. So overall, if you're planning to build a new home or foundation addition here in Southern Ontario, we would always recommend that using ICF as a forming material for a new foundation wall, although it has some great benefits overall, the waterproofing of foundation ICF foundation walls can be quite difficult if the task is not approached properly. So essentially, that's the general breakdown of where, why, and how a project like this comes to pass. So enjoy the full time-lapse video of this project coming up next. Thanks for tuning in, and if you have any questions related to basement waterproofing, foundation repair, or underpinning, give us a shout anytime. We can be reached at wetbasements.com. Thanks again, and we'll see you on the next one.